Oh, she goes to the back rooms. So Viconia says, I thought we were through this already, but Viconia says, actually, dear woman, your husband is fondling another of your kind in the back rooms, a much younger member of your kind, however. We gotta see what goes on. You know how it is. Rumor and press.
Rumor! Rumor!
Hey, darling.
Don't you darling me! You will come home with me this very instant!
Yes, dear.
Jesus.
No, you can't have him. He's mine.
Oh, wow. One more word out of you, wench, and it'll be your last. Pris says, wench? Wench, listen here, you old harpy. Tiana says, harpy? That's it. Rumor says, girls, ladies, don't fight. I can't even help in any way because it'll lower my reputation even further. Why is Viconia still coming up here? Yeah. Oh, they're fighting with knives, daggers. Rumor says, Pris, pumpkin, are you alright? I'm alright, Rumi. The witch didn't hurt me too bad. Oh, so the one who died was his wife. I'm so sorry, Prissy Pumpkin. I didn't know this would happen. Prissy Pumpkin. Sorry, nothing. We're getting married, Rumi. Now. Ugh. Gone for being bossed around from one person to another. Got those. She has a bunch. Okay.
Such menial tasks.
The bigger they are, the harder I hit.
Where are they getting married? Alright, they're gone. Alright. Well, I didn't expect that to happen. All because Viconia was here? Garrol. Wants us to carry her home. Oh, there's Nalia. At least she wait for us. Surly.
When the day be done, the day be done. I wish rest, no argument.
Anomen. Joliv. Greetings, I am Joliv. I have recently arrived from the 10 towns of Icewind Dale. It was a long trek, but I wanted to get the most value I could from the items I had collected up north. Athkatla is known as the richest city in all of Faerûn, so I knew there would be adventurers about with the amount of coin I was looking for. Would you like to take a look at my wares? Sure. Ooh, some interesting... Wow, look at that. Sling of Everard plus 5. Would be like... 2/3 of our money. Koldahar. Axe of Hrothgar. This is all stuff I bet from Icewind Dale. Because Hrothgar, I know that Hrothgar and Koldahar are two cities in Icewind Dale. Or places, I'm pretty sure they're cities. He's got some crazy stuff, but I can't use it right now. Maybe I'll read the descriptions for them. Axe of Hrothgar plus 3. This axe was wielded by an adventurer who lived within the town of Easthaven in Icewind Dale. He died about a century ago trying to rescue his town from the ancient devil Belefet. Oh, is that when the events of Icewind Dale take place? So it's Thaco plus 3, 1d8 plus 3, and gives you plus 1 wisdom and charisma. Interesting. Joril's dagger. Joril was a powerful frost giant that lived with his clan in the spine of the world. His magic dagger was lost when he was killed by a band of adventurers. Eventually, the dagger wound up in the town of Koldahar, where it was reforged so that it could be used as a two-handed sword. Wow. ...25% chance of each hit confusing the target for 3 rounds. Thaco plus 3, 1d10 plus 3, and plus 1 cold damage. It's pretty nice. Defender of East Haven plus 3. This flail was created a century ago to commemorate the defeat of the devil Balafat. It was meant to always remain within the town of East Haven to remind the people of the great evil that has been barely defeated. Well, it's no longer within the town of East Haven. It's here in the slums of Baldur's Gate, Athkatla. Armor class plus 1 and 20% resistance to slashing, piercing, and crushing damage. Thaco plus 3, but 1d6 plus 4. Spear of Koldahar. This stuff's too expensive for me right now. I mean, I can't buy something like this when it's more than the cost of freeing Imoen, so... Which, yes, I will do at some point. Spear of Koldahar plus 3. This spear was forged by the druids who dwelt close to the great tree of Koldahar. It was meant to be used by the warrior who was appointed as Koldahar's defender. Hit points plus 8. Thaco plus 3, which is 1d6 plus 3 piercing. Right, Everard's Morning Star. Plus 2. The Morning Star was the personal weapon of the cleric Everard. Everard was a powerful priest of Tempest who sacrificed his life in the battle against the devil Balafat. 2d4 plus 2, Thaco plus 2, and 50% chance per hit of making target spellcaster lose one spell from memory. Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, this is good stuff, really. Maybe at some point we'll come and buy, you know, a couple of these. When we have, like, hundreds of thousands of gold. Not just 60,000 gold. This was the favorite weapon of the priest of Tempest named Gerard. Gerard sacrificed his life to save the town of East Haven from the powerful devil known as Balafat. We decided all the names for these player characters. Thaco plus 2 and then plus 5 versus demons and devils. Damage 1d6 plus 3, but it's plus 6 versus demons and devils. Yeah, I mean, the characters you make up by yourself, so I don't know if these are actual characters you can meet in the game, or it's just they're choosing names for the player characters. This is crazy, though. Sling of Everard plus 5. The Sling of Everard was a holy weapon created by the god Tempest and given to Everard to help him defeat the enemies of Icewind Dale. When no bullets are equipped, the sling fires missiles that are treated as plus 5 for the purposes of determining what enemies they damage. The missiles receive plus 5 to hit, including the bonus listed below, and deal a total of 1d4 plus 2 missile damage. What if bullets are equipped? Thaco plus 5, damage plus 2. Sapphire really wants this sling. It's sweet. I mean, the one she has now is plus 3, right? Yeah. And it doesn't have any of those special effects. We're out of
rest soon, my friend. I have swords, to be not work. Skills call for careful concentration.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Might as well look at the rest. Ninja Toe of this Scarlet Brotherhood. When a member of the Scarlet Brotherhood kills one of that organization's great enemies, they are often rewarded with this sword. How this sword made its way from the world of Greyhawk, where the Brotherhood is based, to Faerûn is a mystery. When unsheathed, the ninja toe will glow blood red. One extra attack per round. Hit target, takes 6 points of poison damage per round for 2 rounds. Save versus death negates, Thaco plus 3, and it's 1d8 plus 3. Kachiko's Wakazashi. This sword was the favorite weapon of a female warrior named Kachiko. Not much was known about her other than she hailed from the far eastern lands in Karatur. So it's Thaco plus 3, 1d8 plus 3, and drains 2 points of target's wisdom for 2 rounds on each hit. Good for hitting priests with. And finally, the Staff of Arundel. Sounds awesome. This was a lesser version of the Staff of the Woodlands. It was created by Arundel, an Ark druid that lived in the city of Koldahar before he was killed by the devil Belafet. Well, that's sad. Cold resistance and fire, and plus 10, can memorize one extra 5th and one extra 6th level divine spell. Thaco plus 3 and 1d6 plus 3 crushing. Cleric cannot use. Alright. Mage can't use. See, once I look at a staff, I'm like, that's for me.
We must rest soon. Boo is getting squirrely.
So here's Anomen.
Have you changed your minds? Do you wish to strive for good and noble ends?
Well, maybe we can increase our reputation again. If you have, then I am ready to add my martial skill to your repertoire. What say you? I am in need of another warrior. Join with us. I'll do Anomen's quest. Excellent! Adventure and honor await us both. He doesn't have to worry about this stuff. All right, let's go.
We should rest now. I need sleep.
Remove Corrigan. Sorry.
Back to the grind, eh? Are we off?
No, I think we should go our separate ways for now. I'd like me some time to put up me feet anyway. Find me when you're through wandering and want to do some serious travel. I'll be at the Copper Coronet until then. I could tell him, no, don't wait at the Copper Coronet. Wait here, which is the Copper Coronet. Alright, we'll meet you there if we change our minds. Corrigan doesn't care, really. Alright. Let's check this guy out. Leveling up. He's a human fighter cleric. Lawful neutral. Okay. It's not too bad. It's not lawful good. So he's a level 8 cleric and a level 7 fighter. Already has protections on of cold and fire. Oh, we're down to 6? I guess that makes sense. I thought we went from 10 to 7. I guess we went from 9 to 6. Alright, what do we... should we give him, right? We should give him Warhammer as well. I'm sure we can find a good mace for him. What did it say here? I didn't look at it. Okay. Well, I'm going to go back and see what we have. So he has one more weapon proficiency. All saving throws reduced by 2 except for breath weapon. Thaco's reduced by 2. He's got priest spells, plenty of them. 15 hit points, lore increased by 5. Flail. Let's see, what else can you use? What is this, a staff? Oh, it's flail and morning star. Okay. That's plus 3 though. Hmm. That's pretty good. I can give him higher dexterity. That would help. Just trying to see what I should give him proficiency in. That's a halberd. Yeah, he's using bludgeoning weapons. So. Okay, so we have Flail of Ages. This should be sweet. It's got acid and cold damage and fire, and then can slow the target for 20 seconds. That's a long time in the combat. So what does he have now? He has regular bullets. Let me help you out there. Regular sling, regular mace, Delrin family shield. This is Anomen's family shield given to him by his father. In addition to magical protection, this shield radiates an aura that grants the wielder fire and cold resistance. Well, that's where he's getting it from. To protect against range attacks, Anomen can use the shield to erect a field of energy. This protection from normal missiles can be used 3 times per day. So armor class plus 2, and then fire and cold resistance plus 30%. Protection from normal missiles 3 times per day, duration 1 hour. Okay. I'm surprised we can even give it to someone else. I'll give you better armor. And a better shield. And some gauntlets. Actually, what? That adds to it? Wow. Oh, because it helped his dexterity. Which I didn't really look at. He's really good strength. These all really come, guys come with really good strength. Dexterity is 18. Enhanced. Negative 8. The best of all of us. Look at that. Negative 8 armor class. That's crazy. Okay. I wanted to give him something else. Oh yeah, the Helm of Charm Protection. So he's using this, which is a Flail Morning Star. He's better at a mace, but what are you gonna do? With a plus 2 weapon, he might not hit some enemies that we might be encountering. When asked about his past, Anomen is quick to state that he has been serving the Most Noble Order of the Radiant Heart for years, and after his test, he will be a full and true knight. Anomen is reluctant, however, to speak of his noble upbringing, saying only that he entered the Order without the support of his father, Lord Corrit Delrin. Since he could not be sponsored as a squire, Anomen chose the route of the warrior and priest of Helm, the god of guardians, and has fought many battles over the years against forces of evil. Anomen often says that he is confident that he will prove worthy of his knighthood, but sometimes seems to be trying to convince himself of that fact more than anyone. After being... Okay. So this is all his default stuff, right? He needs a better shield. I knew there was something else. I mean, sling. Sling of Seeking plus one. Wait, not that. Look at this guy's head. Yeah, unless they have armor, shield, and weapons, I don't have much on in the way of like belts and boots and stuff like that. Okay. So after he runs out of these bullets, you know, he's using regular bullets. This is probably gonna not be as good. We want to use it without the bullets, this way it'll be plus one. I mean, plus one Thaco. Plus two Thaco. That's funny, though. Oh, it says it's a sling of seeking plus one, but the Thaco and damage are plus two. Yeah, we're not liked at all. Let's go rest.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Hopefully with his quest, our reputation might go up a little. Oh wait, no. We gotta go through his spells. Forgot. Okay, he's got command. Forget about that. Cure light wounds. Bless. Remove fear. There's not much useful on level one, I'm afraid. Bark skin? Meh. I suppose. Silence? Always a good one. Slow poison? Probably won't even work now. I think neutralized poison would be what we need. I'm not going to use this stuff. Miscast magic. Holy smite. Might remove paralysis just in case. Not sure if any of us had that memorized, so. Okay. So here's negative plane protection and cure medium, not moderate. Alright. What else we got? Death ward. Yeah. Lesser restoration. So two of us have this memorized already. So about some more cure moderate or cure medium. Out of these. Cure critical and flame strike probably. And then here, Bolt of Glory, okay, how about the full heal, the full Monty, all right, good, now we'll rest.
Very well.
So does he have quests to undertake? If he does, he's not telling us right now.
Stand back for justice!
What if he doesn't have any quests and he's done all this for nothing?
See battle bow! Run, bow, run!
So bye guys, I'll be right back. Just gonna check to see if there is anything for him. I'll read as little as possible so I don't spoil stuff for myself, but hold on. Okay, there is a quest for him, but we have to wait 5 days.
Make way, villainy! Hero combat kicking for goodness!
All I know is that it has to do with his sister. He's looking for his sister or something. Other than that, I know nothing about the quest. So I already slept 8 hours, and that's kind of ridiculous.
I got some cheap beer for ya.
That should be 3 days. I mean, that should be 1 day. This is 2 days. So cheesy, I know. I still don't do the quest. Okay, it should now be 5 days.
This isn't as wonderful as I thought it would be, traveling with you.
Yeah, just sleeping. I know.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside. Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
I do so miss the burrows. Alright, someone's supposed to approach him. Not a mad, angry peasant. I know after 5 days that would happen.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Not necessarily that we had to be here. I just think his estate is here, and that's some place to go while we wait for someone to go talk to us. Or talk to him. The Delrin Estate, though. That's in the government district, I think. Maybe we'll go look there. You need someone to teach you that. I don't know what to tell you. Delrin Estate. Let's go there. That's him, I think. His last name. The support of his father, Lord Cor Delrin.
The bigger they are, the harder I hit.
Somewhere to go. Well, maybe the resting isn't it. Maybe that won't work that way. Maybe I can talk to his father or something. Delrin Dorgard. Lord Anomen, welcome home. I'm afraid you arrived at a bad time. You should not enter when your father is like this. I shall return when my father is sober. I didn't think he was talking about being drunk.
Stand back for justice!
It's locked. So his father's drunk. And we can't enter at this time. So I'm going to have to see what I can do to get this quest going. If not, then we might just proceed to something else. There's not much, though. This is shouldn't be here. Windspear Hills we need to do. This is entering the sphere, so I'm doing after this other stuff. Has to do with Tolgarius and Galen Bale as well. Trade meat, I want to go. Kangax's body. This involves killing more liches. Maybe we can do that. And Captain Randall, I think this is a mod. And so I'll think about this and think what might transpire. We might have to be in the middle of another quest and get this quest, possibly. But next episode, if I have it right, 789, this should be episode 149. Next episode will be the huge extra special, episode 150. Maybe we'll go to Windspear Hills if we don't get his quest.
City, with all its people and their accumulated wealth, yes?
Yes. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. Hope to see you then in the special huge anniversary episode. And always, seek adventure.